Hello!
Welcome.
It's Improvander.
How are we doing?
We sent this beer from Sweden, from Johan. Idjit. It's an Imperial Stout. From, judged by the internet,
Dougie's
Ale and Potterbryggeri. But yeah, Idjit. Anyway, Idjit, open that. Idjit.
What idiot?
You've got to use it. I know in some parts of America, Idjit is slang for idiot.
It's a lovely...
It's very aromatic. Very floral.
Now, do you get that imperial smell? That's an imperial smell, that is. So many flavours running through. It's like you've got all the dark foods running through. You've got the... It's almost like chocolate and sultanas.
Red fruits and stuff.
Running through all at once, you know what I mean?
Cocoa head with a slight bit of coffee colour. Wow. It's kind of sickly.
It's very strong in the taste.
You get the alcohol.
It's very thin.
Not much. 9.5%.
You
get a lot of the red currants and...
It feels, at the moment...
It starts off creamy on the palate, and then you get a whack of alcohol and red currants.
I think it's like syrupy taste. You know what I mean? Like, you get a syrupy taste.
It is intense, and it's almost like a whiskey kind of taste.
I'd say more like a liqueur.
More of a liqueur.
A chocolate coffee liqueur,
A coffee liqueur with red fruits, and it's kind of intense. There's a slight... Something else there. So we don't read Swedish. I mean, it has that nice taste to it, but it has like a love me or hate me taste.
It sort of stays there though, the taste.
Mm. It's like
come to think of it, right? I was just looking on the cover, right? Now, you see that there?
Yeah.
Now, do you remember that that chocolate sweet with Turkish Delight in it? What were it called?
Turkish Delight?
Yeah, probably was. It was coated in chocolate, remember?
Oh, they did it in Lion, Witch, and the Wardrobe.
Used to have it in bars, didn't they?
Turkish Delight.
And it was Turkish Delight cut in chocolate.
But yeah, in Lion, Witch, and Wardrobe, that as well.
And that there's a slight floral aftertaste I'm getting.
I get the floral in the start as well.
Because you get that, yeah, that's it there. What is it? Fries Turkish Delight.
Yeah.
And that was coated in chocolate.
I agree with what you're saying.
You get that strong taste of chocolate, and then there's intense of it all, and then there's a slight floral aftertaste which Turkish Delight gives you.
And then the other sweets of the variations of Turkish Delight, what they do is get that bit and then just dip it in sugar, and that's what you get. It's very sweet.
Yeah, I mean. Yeah, test.
But yeah, it's Turkish Delight. That's I'm getting that now more and more now you mention it.
Mm, yeah.
And I was never a fan of Turkish Delight before. It was like goes like Marmite. You love it or yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, more and more you mention it. That's what it is.
See, you get that love the chocolate that you just caught in. And then you get a little bit of floral aftertaste.
Mm.
And then it's like...
It's like someone's got some wine, some red wine, and got a Turkish delight, thrown it in a blender, and then...
Coated in chocolate.
Yeah. And then thrown some melted chocolate in there, and then added it to a beer. That's what you get.
Continue.
It's a required taste.
Yeah.
I don't think I'd really want to buy it again. Or if it, my choice to buy it again. But it's one of those beers you've got to try because it's super weird.
Mm.
I mean, just like the Rogue donut beer we had.
Oh, yeah. That, was,
that nice. Was lovely, smoked beer.
A lot of people didn't like it, though, they said.
Yeah, because it depends on your palate. And I think this is the same thing. It's one of those beers you've got to try.
I mean, when we tried it, we were getting a lovely smoky taste, which was when it was warm. But then we tried super chilled, and it was
different again.
And then you were getting the maple or something or taste. Wouldn't you have more? It's like one way or the other. When it's cold. You get the maple taste, and then it's warm, you get the smoky taste. This one, very nice.
It is nice, it's just weird.
You do get a Turkish feel. My guess is that's why they put that on there.
It might be, but it's not Turkish.
I don't know.
It's Swedish.
It's a Swedish version.
Yeah. I mean, like I said, it's one of those you've got to try.
Yeah.
But anyway. You take care.
Bye.